first time.
No. And then you hit it and then like looked around. That was the take that worked. Look at us.
We're back.
Radiocast. Let's go. Welcome in. Yeah. Radiocast, April 5th.
Yeah.
Is that the date?
Wow. Rolling right through this spring here. Punxsutawney was not kidding when he said it was starting.
But then he lied to us.
Oh, right. The snow yesterday.
Snowed. It did literally snow. Yesterday. Yeah. I had to shovel my driveway yesterday when I got home.
Oh. Ridiculous.
It was hard, too. It was heavy.
So you know how the plows come through and they leave like the big bump at the bottom? I ignored that. I was like, too heavy. We're just going to deal with it for a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I did like the walkway and then I was like,
it's good enough. It's good. Nice. Yeah. I haven't ordered anything lately. Nobody's going to be coming down the walkway.
No.
Or do you need the walkway to get to your house?
You kind of need it. And like for our dogs.
Oh, yeah.
I guess.
The little one doesn't want to walk on
the
slush.
We have the walkway to our driveway, which we have to shovel, but then the walkway to like the road.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, I guess we'll shovel it.
Oh, yeah. We just have the one from our door to the driveway.
Oh,
so, we need it.
Right.
It's not long.
Right. Yeah, that's what you got to do. Anywho, welcome in. How are you guys doing?
Good. Yeah.
It's Friday.
Oh, love so that it's Friday.
Friday radio cast? This is pretty good.
This is what you want.
This is the ideal way to spend a work day.
Right. Especially in the afternoon. This is it.
Yeah.
Right.
Then it's the weekend.
Right. After this, we're done.
We're leaving.
Oh, man. Yeah. So I guess the first thing we were going to talk about was an event that happened today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Northeast experienced an earthquake.
Yeah.
I can't remember ever experiencing an earthquake.
Me either.
No. But not I didn't, that this it was didn't like, even experience it's like it's not this so one.
Bad. Yeah, I didn't feel it, but apparently a lot of people did. It originated in New Jersey.
Yes.
So it mainly affected New York, but like Philly and like Connecticut felt it too.
And it was like a 5.5. Is that what they said it was?
I think it's 4.8.
4.8. I just pulled a number out of nowhere.
Fairly close.
It was a pretty big one.
It is. It's pretty high for area, I think.
Is it out of 5?
It's out of 10.
Oh, it's out of 10.
But
like a 9 is like, you know, disaster, like buildings falling, like that kind of stuff.
Like a movie, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the one
the earth just opens up.
Right. There was just one in a different country, and I am blanking on the country, and I don't want to guess, but there was like a 7.5 there.
And that was a big
deal. Buildings like collapsed.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah. And I think New York usually has like a 1 to 2-ish if they've had them in the past. And so this was like pretty big.
Yeah, it is we're big. Not exactly on a fault line or anything. So,
yeah.
We don't have to play the blame game.
Yeah, man.
We're not. Yeah. So. But yeah, still kind of crazy that happened. So I was in my car and I was like, is someone jumping on the car? Or like I was parked.
As you do.
As I was someone playing a joke and like, and then I thought maybe the wind was like blowing it.
Because you were parked.
Yeah, I was parked. Yeah. And then it wasn't either of those things.
Right.
Turns out it was an earthquake.
Yeah.
And then, and I thought the car was like idling. Like I was like about to get out. And then I'm glad the car's fine.
Right.
Because it was just an earthquake.
The earth. Yeah.
It's just the earth shaking.
Just the earth shaking.
Quaking.
People in the building were like, I felt a shake. I didn't, and I'm not calling them liars.
But
Ari, your wife,
yes, came right. Also works here.
As,
yes,
as you're familiar.
Yeah.
She came over and was like, did you just feel, like, was there just an earthquake? And I didn't.
She was saying her screens.
Her monitors in her classroom, she has a bunch. She said they're all shaking.
Right.
Which
I feel like that's a sensitive enough thing to like,
right?
Give it
that's,
away.
That's
if you
something
didn't have
you
like
a
sign.
I mean, but I was staring at my computer monitor too. I don't know if it was more securely attached to the.
Got a nice two-footed monitor.
Right, but she first came in and just said, "Did you just feel that earthquake?" And I was like, "No, I didn't." But I didn't want to be like, "You just made it up. You just came over here and
you're losing your mind.
Yeah, you're going crazy sitting in that room."
Is that a walrus?
But then she said her
front door.
Yeah. then she said her monitors were all shaking. So I was like, all right, I guess you can't really make that up.
Right, right, right.
And then it was Rory, actually, down at the tech office, did a quick Google search. And people over on r/Boston, bunch of posts were coming in like, did you guys feel that earthquake? Did you guys feel that? And so, yeah, I guess she wasn't making it up. And yeah. I was making up the fact that there wasn't an earthquake.
I know, like, I wish I felt it just to, like.
Yeah, just to know.
Say that
just to be like, yeah, I did feel it.
Just to see what it's like.
Where were you when the earthquake happened?
Yeah.
Right. My office, in my well-protected office, I guess.
Yeah.
Bring it on. Bring on the next one. I'm.
You're safe.
I'm not feeling a thing.
Oh, well, man. So Jimmy, my boyfriend, lives in New York, and we were talking about something completely different. And I saw like the preview of the text was like, not to change the subject, and I was like, ugh. This guy. And then I opened the text, and it was not to change the subject, but there was just an earthquake. I was like, oh my God.
What curveball. What could he possibly want to yap about now?
Yeah, and he said, like, their whole building shook. Like, things were, like, rattling for, like, over 10 seconds.
Wow.
And he was like, some people have survival instincts and, like, ran outside. And he was like, I was just in my little office, like, what the heck is going on?
People got up and, like, ran outside?
Yeah, because you're supposed to be outside. Collapsed. Yeah, I guess that's the safest spot. But he was like, I didn't know that. I've never experienced one.
Oh, man. I was outside. You guys were inside,
jokes,
though.
Jokes on the people that ran outside. It was a bit of a nothing burger. Come on.
Yeah.
So where did they get their training that they're just like, ah, I'm out of here?
I know.
Are they just from California and they're just used to it?
Maybe. Because, like, when I think about it, I'm like, yeah, that makes sense. You don't want to, like, be inside of a building if it collapses. But also, like, I wouldn't have thought to go outside. Most natural disasters, it's the opposite.
Right.
Don't
go
outside. Yeah.
I guess the doorway thing makes sense.
Book it.
Because you'd be, like, under.
It's reinforced.
Yeah. Yeah. Or, like, a basement, maybe. Like, a really deep basement. It's, like,
I think that's tornadoes.
Yeah, I think if you're in a basement, you might be covered in
rubble. Thinking of tornadoes. If it falls.
Tornadoes, though. And what is that, like a fallout shelter?
Yeah, if we want.
That's a bomb.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what that is.
Or tornado.
Tornado. Yeah. They have like tornado fallout shelters, right?
Yeah. Well, no, I feel like fallout shelter refers specifically to the nuclear fallout.
Right.
Tornado, you just call it a shelter. A bunker.
A bunker. Yeah, that's what I meant.
Right.
Bunkers, Hudson has had a lot of tornadoes, though, recently. Don't you feel like in the past few years?
Yeah. They have had a couple.
Not to change the subject.
Oh, man. This guy.
But there's a tornado coming.
On my route to certain buildings on my campus in Boston, I would pass by this sign that said nuclear fallout shelter, and it had the radiation symbol.
Wow.
And so somewhere in Boston on Tremont Street, there's, I don't know, you know, probably underground, I guess someone's got a nuclear fallout shelter ready to go.
Who was like the one who championed that effort? Just be like, hey,
I don't know.
We should put one of these in.
Yeah.
Well, that scares
put
me.
Put a sign so that people know
that
this is where we're coming.
It's like a huge, like.
Yeah. They built it in like the 50s, being like, we got to be prepared.
The entirety of Boston is an underground, right. Like city
it's
waiting.
Like we're third on the list for. You know, cities getting hit.
Right.
We got to get ready.
Oh, man.
Do you think it would be, like, exclusive, though? Like, only so many people would be allowed
well,
in.
You wouldn't put a sign out there, would you?
Well, that's what,
that's what
like,
I'm saying. It's
going to
be, like, the size of Boston, just underground.
Because usually I feel like it would be kind of, like, a secret of, like, well, we can't take everybody.
Right.
So, like, worst case scenario, we'll send out a message to a few people, and they can bring 10 people each. But instead, they're just, like.
Very clearly. Labels.
It's just people who've been on Tremont Street.
I mean,
the sign.
I mean, there's a chance that just a funny sticker that this guy found and was like, I'm going to put it on.
That
this.
Would also be funny.
I think it was like a parking garage. Like, there was the entrance to the parking garage, and then, like, next to it was. So, I don't know.
Just FYI.
Right.
In case you need it.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, so, natural disasters are.
I guess.
Worrisome.
Should we get the high school to build a bunker? Is that what I'm.
Yeah.
Do we need that, apparently?
Oh, man.
I mean, first the earthquakes. Who knows what's next?
Right, and the tornadoes.
Tornadoes, apparently. That are
always happen when we're here, too.
Cropping up out of nowhere.
And we're always encouraged to, like, hide in
and
the closet.
We are the last to know about these things because of our windowless.
Yeah.
True. So I feel like living in New England, historically, there's never been anything natural disaster wise that's right, like devastated
Hurricane Sandy like made its way sort of up to us, but even that was like,
yes, thank you for knocking on wood. Yep. But also whenever people are like, stay inside, like hunker down, I'm like, it's never happened here. I don't know what to tell you.
Until it does.
We've had this conversation before. But it never had. Like, historically, you'd think it would have happened here before.
But that's what I'm saying. Like,
if you're in Oklahoma and you've got a tornado touching down, you're like, holy smokes, this could be bad.
The tiniest things are like, guys, like, there's a hurricane. And it's Hurricane Sandy that, you know, by the time it gets to us, is a tropical storm again.
Right.
Or like, guys, there's an earthquake. It was a 0.2 by the time it got to us.
Yeah.
So there was...
Maybe that's a bad, like, mentality to have for me, but I just feel like if it's never happened...
But you're just...
Well, gonna catch up to you.
I mean, you're just like Jimmy. You wasted no extra time running out of the building.
Right.
You stayed inside, looked around, got your work done.
Yeah.
So a few months before... I think it was a few months before you got hired. It was that summer.
Oh, I missed
it. It was just me and you, and there was, like, one of those big tornadoes coming to Hudson.
Right.
And we were encouraged to hunker down until it ended here. And
also,
you,
this was at like 3:30 in the afternoon.
And you were like, it started to like just rain, I think. So like the tornado hadn't hit yet, but was like on its way.
It's like
and
in the next 45 minutes is going to be a tornado. I'm like,
So you took your bike. So I can get home, right?
Yeah. He had taken his motorcycle.
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah.
And you were like, I can't wait. I have to go right now. Yeah, so you like sped home, but someone in the building was like, he left? Like, what? And I was like, well, he had to. I
mean, yeah, on his motorcycle?
Far better to drive before a storm.
Right up.
And I remember you, like, either texted or the next day, you were like, it started to, like, torrential downpour when you were, like, almost home.
Yeah.
So you were like, thank God I left.
Yeah, it was a good call.
Yeah.
And guess what? No tornadoes scooped me up. So I was
happy. Yeah, you're good today. So when they say don't drive in a tornado...
Just drive before the tornado. Yeah.
Go fast.
Just be
go
faster
now.
Than the tornado.
Obviously.
It's like, you know, when the trailers are playing, like, oh, do I got to go to the bathroom? Yeah, go now. Movie's about to start.
Yeah.
And you want to be here for that.
Exactly.
Well, the movie Twister did scare me. I saw it for the first time, like, a couple years ago.
I don't think I've ever seen it.
Did you know I'm making a sequel / reboot?
Yeah, I don't know which one it is.
They're just making another Twister movie.
It's kind of scary.
Presumably about the same exact thing that happened in the first
tornadoes.
One.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a little scary.
Right.
It's too real. I'm like, we don't need movies like this. Like, stick to light alien movies.
San Andreas.
That was one of those random movies that my dad had on VHS. And he had a minivan with a VHS player like in it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so that was one of those random movies that I saw like a handful of times when I was like 8.
Oh, gosh.
It's like, yeah, pop this on. Here you go.
Can I get the Lion King, Dad? Yeah. Like, jeez.
Nope, got this one.
There's that Twister. Oh, man. Wow. All right, well, that's our natural disaster talk, I think, for the day. Hopefully everyone in New Jersey and New York were good.
Northeast, yeah.
Sounds like nothing too serious, but...
I think it was just like...
Got to experience
what
earthquake.
I've seen. Like, just... intense shaken for a little bit, but everyone's okay.
It's enough to raise some eyebrows.
Right.
Yeah.
So this is our radio cast. We got some music. This week we did...
Slow jams.
Just slow it down.
Yeah, we're just going to slow
feel
it down.
Feel the vibe. All right.
So first up is you.
Oh, nice. Get my picks in early. So here we go. Zach Bryan and I Remember Everything.
Yes.
Rotgun whiskey's gonna ease my mind. Beach town dress on the drying line. Do I remind you of your daddy in his 88 Ford? Labrador hanging out the passenger door. The sand from your hair is blowing in my eyes. Blame it on the beach, grown men don't cry. Do you remember that beat down basement couch? I'd sing you my love songs and you'd tell me about how your mama ran off and pawned her ring. I remember everything. A cold shoulder, a closing time, you begging me to stay till the sun rose. Strange words come on out of a grown man's mouth when his mind's broke. Pictures and passing time, you only smile like that when you're drinking. I wish I didn't, but I do remember every moment on the nights with you.
You're drinking everything to ease your mind. You're like concrete feet in the summer heat. It burns like hell when two souls meet. No, you'll never be the man that you always swore. But I'll remember you singing in that 88 Ford. A cold shoulder, a closing time. You were begging me to stay till the sun rose. Strange words. Come on out of a grown man's mouth when his mind's broke. Pictures and passing time, you only smile like that when you're drinking. I wish I didn't, but I do remember every moment on the nights with you.
Cold shoulder, closing time, you begging me to stay till the sun rose. Strange words come on out of a grown man's mouth when his mind's broke. Pictures and passing time, you only smile like that when you're drinking. I wish I didn't, but I do remember every moment on the nights with you. Rock dirt whiskey's gonna ease my mind. Beach towel dress on the drying line. Do I remind you of your daddy in my 88 Ford? Labrador hanging out the passenger door.
There you go. Little Zach Bryan, country guy. Slowing it down for a second.
Yeah.
Not too bad. Good slow jam. It's on my slow jams list.
Nice. Oh, do you have a slow jam
playlist? Absolutely.
That's awesome.
Slow jams, throwback or old school jams, and the other one's like current jams or something. But I have to have those lists in there.
Mm-hmm.
So is your light songs?
That's like my library, and then I pull from that and make playlists.
Okay. Yeah. So I know some people keep the light songs, like there's barely anything in it, and they just like have playlists. And
stuff. That's kind of what I do. Really? My playlist is my like songs.
Yeah.
Just, right.
Yeah.
But you like remove things sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Stuff. Yeah. Mine is
too much to make playlists.
Oh, yeah. You have 188 songs in your like songs. I have 600.
Oh, yeah. Just like it's easy. And then you're like, what was that song? Oh, there it is. Boom. You clean it up. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
You make a playlist or do you just get rid of?
I just get rid of the songs that I find myself skipping all the time.
Wow.
I try to do that. Like, if I notice, like, oh, I never listen to this anymore.
I'm due for a cut. 188 is too much. Because if I add a song, I want to hear that song again.
Right.
I don't want to wait 188 songs till I get round back to it.
It's at, like, the top, right?
Yeah.
Well, no, the way Spotify shuffles, they'll bury it in the dirt. And so you got to...
Oh, yeah.
Their shuffle is horrible. Shuffle's
horrible.
Just don't play shuffle, though.
It will also play the same, gotta like, play 20 shuffle. Songs.
Got to shuffle it up.
I don't know if you have to. I think if you like that song, you just like have this like current list. That's kind of what. That's
lately, like. I have been going just chronological from the top.
Yeah. You're like, oh, that's that song.
Yeah.
But then you hear the same songs in order every time.
Well, then you hit shuffle.
Or you know what I love listening to? My on repeat that like Spotify just makes for you. It's like 20 songs you always repeat.
Huh.
And I will only shuffle that playlist sometimes.
Oh, yeah,
so then
good.
Like the on repeat never changes though. It's always but it's perfect.
Spotify's like, we updated your on repeat but it's all the same things. Like, are you sure you? And you're like, views. That's what I. It's helpful. That's what I was looking for.
Yeah, I like to do when I want just like a genre. Like, it's nice to have the playlists because I can jump in and be like, I'm in this mood, you know, country mood, or
I should make
driving, more. You know, whatever.
I do have one for when I drive like to New York.
Yeah.
That I usually update because it's just like, I know for the next 3 hours I'm going to want to hear these songs. Mm-hmm. I don't want to worry about the other ones.
Right. Look at us getting into the Spotify.
We're talking tunes.
Radiocast.
Really strategic with Spotify.
Oh, man.
Do you have a workout playlist?
There is a... I like the pre-made ones because they just give me like different stuff, I guess, that I'm not always listening to.
Yeah.
But sometimes there's like a basketball one that I'll use, which sometimes has basketball jams on it. Sometimes it's just pretty much a workout, like slightly upbeat music. Right. But either way, that's those usually work pretty good. Or if there's like a running one, is usually pretty good.
Yeah. Sometimes it's like the beat matches like when your feet would be the ground.
That's when I'm running perfect. Up a hill and you hit a good beat.
Mm-hmm.
And you're just like, why am I going so fast up this hill? But it feels good. So cool. Then you get to the top and the song ends. You're like, I'm dead.
Oh, there's one song that I always listen to. It's Will I Am and Justin Bieber from years ago. It's called That Power. And like the beat is perfect for like when you're running the whole time. And it's like a 5 minute song. Yes, this is perfect.
The fastest runner.
So
ever.
Good.
Oh, man. Yeah. I like Spotify. Do you guys, have you only Spotify'd or have you Apple Music or anything else?
I started using Spotify, I think, before Apple Music even came out. So I just stuck with it.
Yeah, when Spotify like was on the rise, I got in pretty early. And it hasn't disappointed.
No.
Yeah. I used to just like buy songs from iTunes like right before college. That's I started doing that. And then I would like... go through the effort of downloading like CDs onto my iPhone.
Yeah,
nice.
And then I finally was like, I can afford $9 a month.
Right.
Like, it's worth
it. Really
it
really is a game changer to have every single song ever.
Right.
Yeah.
I think I did like a week of the free Spotify, but then I would use it every day when I was driving to school. So I was like, this is worth it.
And the ads, they were killing.
The ads were killing me, right.
Yeah.
Right. If I got an ad on my 10-minute drive to school in the morning, I was like, that was it.
Yeah. I went through the phase of there was the downloading of music, which I don't know how good that was. And then there was the like YouTube like rip music. Mm. So you just like grab those.
Yeah.
But those like would go into iTunes and be like, not really sure what this song is.
Right.
And then like the art wouldn't be like it was like a whole thing.
It was time consuming.
Yeah. And then you've had like this one great library in Apple and iTunes, and then Spotify came out and was like, "Hey, that library is cool, but here's every single song.
Yeah,
maybe you want this."
I also used to listen to Pandora all the time in high school.
Oh, yeah, Pandora was fun.
Ads, and you have no choice
right.
of what you're listening to.
Right. Yeah, that's a shuffle for
just the radio,
right?
Just like related stuff.
Which now Spotify has radio.
Which I like the radio sometimes.
Right.
Especially when I want
it is
like
good, but
a
it's
new
like,
song.
Now you don't need Pandora at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True. It is. I like the like discovering songs that way.
Yeah.
You'd be like, I love this jam. What else is kind of similar?
What else is like that?
Yeah.
I've done that a lot. We just got into a music talk.
Yeah.
There's a lot to say about it.
Yeah.
It is interesting hearing how other people curate their music.
Right. You like a lot of the classic rock.
Yeah. History picked out the good songs for me. I just have to, you know, find it.
Who would you say is your like biggest music influence like around you, like a person?
Oh, 1,000%.
Not like a celestial.
Right. 1,000% Pat for sure. Friend of the show, Pat Fortuna.
Yeah, we had him on episode 2.
I don't know. Whatever episode it was. For sure him. Well, it started with my dad. My dad would play a lot of the 80s classics.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of where I got my base for it. And then Pat had a similar taste in music, but had a much wider
breath.
You know, finger on the pulse of everything.
Yeah, he's and a so, big music guy. We had him on for his music.
Right. And then we played Rock Band together. And Rock Band, we'd play a Rock Band song, and I'd be like, gotta add that to the playlist.
Nice. Yeah, that's good. I think it's funny to see like who's,
yeah,
because it's people you're around, like whatever they like. You're like, oh wait, maybe I'm into this.
Yeah.
What about you?
I feel like different like genres came from different people.
Yeah.
But probably my dad, because he would always like have me listen to like Fleetwood Mac or like. When I was younger, my mom was talking about this the other day. He would give me his like Spice Girl CD.
Nice.
And I would put it in like the Walkman, and like, or even as a baby, she was saying like they'd drive around and play it in the car, and my feet would kick.
Yeah.
Spice Girls. Nice. So he That's showed good. Me like older stuff, and I feel like otherwise I wouldn't have listened mm-hmm. to that.
Yeah.
But yeah, and then I met one of my friends in college, and that was the first time I ever really started listening to like rap. I'd mm-hmm. never listened to it before. Oh, yeah. And I was like, oh, this is like not just like Eminem. This is like other really good right. artists.
Yeah. There is, yeah. Nice.
Also, though, Glee.
Yeah.
Introduced me to so many songs that yeah. now I love the originals of. But at the time, I was like, this is such a good song.
It was
song
just Glee on the...
They did a really good job.
I do love when like a show or like a soundtrack or even like a commercial has like a song that you're like, mm-hmm. I've heard this and I like it and like I gotta find it. And
yeah,
it's always fun. Yeah, I think I'm with you with like the genres from different people.
Mm-hmm.
My parents obviously they like some of the old school between classic rock and like the disco upbeat stuff. I think my mom liked that. And then my sister and I got into country like in high school, so there was like just all the country songs on playlists and mm-hmm. all kinds of stuff. And then, I don't know, I guess myself, like, I just kind of have liked, like, the Macklemore and some of, like, the, I don't know, I guess it's kind of pop, but singer-songwriter-y pop. And, yeah, and Ari likes a lot of, like, alternative rock stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I like that stuff. Even kind of leaning into folk a little bit with, like, Lumineers or, mm-hmm. like, that kind of stuff. Yeah. But then also some, like, different, less known artists that she likes. But yeah, I like all kinds of stuff.
I have found many songs because of you.
Because of me, yes. that's a great compliment.
Just like the songs you test like audio with.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Or sometimes.
It's just blaring through a stadium. Yeah. Like, oh, yeah. This is pretty good.
There's been like a lot. And then I remember vividly just because like that was the first time I was like, oh, it's such a good song. I knew the song Ribs by Lord, but I never really listened to it.
Oh,
and
yeah.
then one day Ari posted a video of you guys like renovating your house, but it had that song like,
oh, nice.
Really loud in it. And I was like, what is this? This is so good.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I am a sucker for like new pop songs that have like a good beat. It's just like fun to have this is catchy.
TikTok and Reels, just like background songs that people are putting on. You're like, oh, that's, it's and it's easy because you can just click on it right in the reel. Or
right. Easy to find it, yeah.
And it's how so many new artists get huge now is through mm-hmm. TikTok.
Shout out. Once again, shout out Benson Boone.
Right.
Yeah.
Beautiful Things is being, I've seen it in so many reels.
A TikTok thing?
I've seen it
being, yeah.
Oh.
That's what he started as. But yeah, I see it all the time too. Beautiful Things is used.
That's crazy.
Like the drop.
We always make
the
it back to Benson Boone somehow, don't we? It's a defining
HUD-TV's favorite musician.
HUD-TV's sponsor.
Sponsored, right.
Oh, man. Well, we just kind of accidentally had a music segment.
Yeah.
But I loved it.
Right.
Do we want to hit another song? Yeah.
I'll roll right into it. This was a song that my dad would play in the car, and I liked it. And it was only until years later that I knew it was a Journey.
Is it on the 188 playlist?
It's not. It's a little too slow to keep in the regular playlist, but it's on the peripheral.
Yeah, holds a place in your heart. Yeah.
Lights.
When the lights go down in the city.
Very good.
Nice. Good pick.
Yeah.
Classic.
Oh, that song.
Oh, man. All right. Another thing we wanted to get into. We're getting out of winter.
Mm-hmm.
We did have a big snowstorm, but we're on our way out.
So we're
leaving behind. We're
tripping out of winter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stumbling.
Yeah. But we're leaving behind the seasonal depression, hopefully.
Yeah.
We were talking the other day, just like some things. How it just feels good to get up, be active, mm-hmm. do something worthwhile, sometimes hard, sometimes
right. just
an activity that's not sitting, you know, kind of leaving yourself
right.
on autopilot. You know, you're actually engaging with the world or doing something to better yourself or feel good. I was just wondering what you guys, if anything, you've felt like something that you like to do to kind of get that feeling.
Well, I'll start with
especially this time of year.
The best day for my mental health is when daylight savings begins.
Oh,
because
that's so
true. That instant extra hour of sunlight, oh, the world of difference.
It's true.
The world of difference.
Yeah.
And it's just like in that moment, you're like, it's over.
it's behind us. Yeah.
Sunsets at 4 p.m. are done.
So what are you doing with that extra light, though?
honestly, like even the little things of like eating dinner when it's light out or like yeah. eating dinner on the deck, like outside, like oh, eating man. Outside yeah. at restaurants. Yeah.
That's amazing.
That's so good.
We're not quite there yet, but
we're not right. Yeah. We're not quite wait. There yet, but it's becoming the opportunity there. You know, restaurants are putting out the patio furniture
right,
and you're
right,
like, oh, right. here we go.
Right. And I mean, not to speak for you, but one thing you've taken on a coaching job. That's
yeah.
like an endeavor to be
right.
to be involved with.
And it's just like, you know, a couple hours outside guaranteed
right.
every day.
Was that part of your decision when you were doing that? Just to be like, hey,
I'll hang
get
outside
something to
for
do.
A bit.
Yeah. Love baseball.
I think so because baseball was my favorite sport to play. And 90% of it was because of the atmosphere.
Right.
Of like springtime. Mm-hmm. We're just hanging out outside like. I never really played in any of my sports, so, but it was way better.
Big team guy, big locker room guy.
Big locker room guy, unsung hero. But it was way better to sit on the bench of baseball because you're outside enjoying the
yeah.
nice air,
right.
whereas like you're sitting on the bench of basketball, you're like, all right, it's still dark out at 4, like I'm going to walk outside and it's freezing.
Yeah.
But yeah, baseball is just fun, and the chatter, you
right.
got to yell to your teammates on the field.
Baseball definitely, especially when it starts, it just feels like spring. Like spring training.
I mean, I was with
news comes in, teams get outside.
Yeah.
People are out playing on the fields, and it's like,
right.
oh, all right, we're outside again. This feels good.
Right. I was with my other JV2 coach, and we had finished up with our eighth graders because we were just doing something off to the side. But the varsity was doing an intra-squad scrimmage out
nice.
In the outfield. And so we walked over, hung out there for a little bit, and it was just like, pitch comes in. And then, like, you know, strike called or whatever. And then it's both sides yapping, like, side yelling to the batter, like, the team that was batting. They're like, oh, come on, like, square them up here. And the field, they yell into the pitcher, hey, good pitch, whatever. Like, everyone's got nicknames for each other.
Right.
And I just turned
good camaraderie.
Right, I just turned to the other coach, and I was just like, I just love baseball.
Yeah.
And dudes hanging outside and just yapping to each other all it's good. You know, for 2 hours.
Sports in general are just a productive thing for kids and for adults. Just to, like, you're not on your phone. You're not in front of a screen. You're outside.
Right.
You're getting better at something, presumably, and, like, working on it and competing.
Yeah.
Good stuff. And you get a little responsibility, too, which is a new role in baseball for you. Just to, like, kind of teach, pass it on, show them how to bunt, how to do all this stuff.
It's cool. You get to wave them around third.
Yeah.
That's the best part.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you may have sat on the bench, but now you're the coach.
Right.
Right.
Who's laughing now?
Exactly.
And Sarah, you were saying you were getting active too, right?
Yeah. I started running again, which I used to do all the time in high school and college. And haven't for a really long time. But we were talking about how last week, I was just like kind of feeling gross.
I would
go home from work and be excited to like have free time, but then I was just using it to do like nothing. Yes. Which is sometimes fine. Right. You need it. But like after like a whole winter of that, I was like, I'm doing nothing. Mm-hmm. I need to do something to like feel good about myself. So I started running again.
Nice.
And I started yoga just like at home on YouTube. Which is
so good.
Hard and a little awkward, but like I'm making myself do it.
Right. Yeah. Some of the moves in yoga are just like, wait, what do you want me to do?
And my body does not do that.
I'm going to need a couple of weeks before I'm doing like that move.
I always have a sour taste of yoga because I feel like growing up, you're like, yoga, it's the relaxing thing. Yeah. And then we would do like a yoga section in wellness. And I was like, this is hard.
It's hard.
Right.
I feel like after I'm done, I'm like, wow, I feel like great. You know, like it benefits you more than I think you realize.
Well, it's just, I never, like, it's a workout.
Yeah, for sure.
And I didn't know that. So I would, like, do it. And I'm like, this is hard. This is a workout. Yeah. What is happening?
This is supposed to be relaxing.
So, like, meditative yoga is the more, like, relaxing thing.
Right.
Yeah.
They also have hot yoga, which I've done once, which is crazy thing
that
for me to
hard.
Be able to have done. Yeah,
were you just,
I
like,
was,
completely dehydrated?
It was hot. It was, like, it's like 90-something degrees in this room. And I don't know how I got there. I think Ari was involved. She was like, want to do this? And I was like, seems like a lot for me. I'm usually a pretty sweaty person. But we went for it. But it was nice. But it was hot. And I just prefer maybe not to do it in the heat.
But that's like so cool you did that together.
Right. And I could say I've done hot yoga, which is, I feel like, that'd be a good three truths and a lie for me. Like, I've done hot yoga.
Yeah.
No way. Not this year.
Isn't it like an hour long, too?
Yeah, yeah. I was like, oh, my God.
Like a lot.
Just like sucking down water.
Right.
But I do like yoga. I want to kind of get into a routine.
That's good.
Yeah.
Definitely beneficial.
Especially as like, not that I'm that old, but in my 30s, you just get like stiff if you're not
can't touch your toes as well.
You
gotta stay limber.
It's super helpful because like I have like shoulder and neck problems, so I originally started just doing a 10-minute one that's just targeted that area.
Yeah,
and afterward, like it feels so good. Like it feels so loose and like weightless.
Yeah.
So that's helpful, and then yesterday for the first time I did a full body one, and it wasn't like I don't think it was supposed to be hard. Like it was like basic stretches.
The
that,
person
like,
doing the
do.
Moves did not find it hard.
No, like
but people following along.
I think I had told you like it, one part you're in like a downward dog, so like all fours, but like your butt's really high in the air. Yeah. And then she was like, okay, drop your heel to the ground, and I was like, oh, I can't. What are you talking about? I can't put my heel down without sitting down.
So true.
But yeah.
And the running, I feel like running is just like a meditative almost, because you just
is,
you know, just go, just jogging definitely gets the heart rate up and you're getting your cardio in, but it's less than like a sport where you're thinking about the sport, you know. With running, you're just kind of like locked in, you could think about stuff. I don't know, it's kind of therapeutic. I feel like
it is. Yeah. And like a couple days ago, I did 2 miles for the first time in
pretty
a really
good.
Long time.
Pretty good.
Nice. But at first when I started, I was like, I feel awful. This does not feel good. But then, like, you know, when you hit that feeling, like after being in so much pain, suddenly it like becomes so easy. Like if you're running, you hit that, and I was like, oh my gosh, I was going to stop at 1 mile and then I went to two. And I was like, I think I could keep going. Yeah. But I made myself, I didn't want to overdo it.
I want to be the best at running right now. right out the gate, my second day.
Yeah. And like the endorphins. That's what it is, right?
Yeah.
I think
not a science radiocast. You're on. Right.
It makes you feel good.
Yeah.
And it always makes me feel kind of bad because, like, whenever I'm like, oh, I feel gross, my mom is like, you should go to the gym or like do yoga. And I'm always like, Mom, come on.
What do you know?
Suggestions.
And then I come home and I'm like, I feel amazing. Yeah. She's like, yeah, I know.
I've been telling you.
Oh, man. Yeah. They're always right. Always right.
What about you?
Well, I've been trying to do, I've been listening to some different podcasts and kind of like that better you type stuff. And I think just kind of in the same lines, I have been trying to work out a little bit more, playing basketball and doing some like light jogs and stuff around the neighborhood. But what's been more is doing like, I've been trying to do maybe one thing that's good for me a day and one hard thing a week.
Mm-hmm.
And that could be physically, emotionally, socially, all these different things. And again, I got this from like a couple different podcasts and stuff. Mm-hmm. But I've been feeling better just like mood wise and like just like more energy, more clearness. I don't know. So like one thing, simple thing, but I think this is a bigger thing that people, you know, some people are really into, but the cold exposure, like a cold tub or cold showers even. So I've tried to just a couple mornings a week, like start the day with just jumping into like cold shower for like 2 minutes. And it does wake me up. And like, I guess there's science behind it that endorphins are some kind of hormone when your body's like reacting to that and the adrenaline starts to like warm you up, the like shock factor. It does release whatever like good feeling things that you need to start your day and wakes you up, makes you feel a little bit more alive. And then, I don't know, you're going into the day with a better mood than maybe not. Mm. So that's been good. Another little adjustment was I got a book, actually off of a recommendation from the podcast, but just before bed, instead of like playing on your phone and getting that like whatever dopamine hits you get from Facebook or TikTok or Instagram, like instead I'm reading a book and it's kind of about some of the similar stuff. And about like being a dad and parenting, which is kind of a hobby, I guess now.
Right.
Because
I dabble in parenting.
Yeah, I dabble in parenting because I have to, but also because I love to. But no, that's interesting. And instead of being on my phone at that time, I'm learning different things or having a different perspective and reading, and then fall right to sleep because you're not like racing with the social media stuff. So it's been good. I feel like it's helped kind of boost the mood out of the seasonal depression time of, you know, winter, and kind of feel good for spring. It's good to kind of work on some stuff and try to better yourself.
And has Maeve ever woken up while you're reading your book and, you know, tried to distract you, and you're like, Maeve, I'm doing this for you. I'm reading this book
about parenting. Yeah. Go away. Usually she's pretty sound asleep at this point.
Together.
Yeah. But definitely some interesting stuff. And it's always nice to have new perspectives on things. Actually, one of the words I think I told you the other day that kind of stuck with me, which is like a simple thing, but just the word vitality, just being like strong and active. I think everybody, guys, girls, anybody should strive for that, at least at some point in their day, to do something that's like a little bit physical or just active and gets you engaged in something other than like, you know, a device or technology or something like that. So I think just having that perspective and that idea of like vitality, I don't know, just sounds like something you want in your life.
Right.
You know, and I think in today's world, often it's not something that's happening as much as it should. There's a lot of distractions. So, yeah, just trying to, I mean, parenting wise, you can see why that's kind of connected.
Right.
You know, when you typically love screens or like we're not iPad people or anything like that. We want their kids to engage with the world. And
you want to be able to keep up with your kids as they grow up.
Yeah, it's good for me. And I feel like this perspective and these things I'm thinking about now will be good for them. And
you can only beat Bodhi in basketball for so long before he's got to.
But I got to extend it as long as I can. Get that out of here.
Yeah, you have to be the dad that when you're like older is still able to
play basketball. Let's go.
Right.
Even when he's like 25 and is like ready and you're like, yeah.
Yeah.
I can
do that. That's right. That's the goal.
It's been nice too. I feel bad that you have not been here for any of our motivational conversations together. Yeah. But it's been nice that since we like had the first talk on like Tuesday.
Yeah, we've
You've come in and been like, what'd you do last night? And I've been like, oh, I did yoga. Or like, I went to the gym. And you're like, nice.
That's good.
And now I'm like, dang, I have to do something. I have
my guaranteed 2 hours outside. I think I'm locked in for a little bit.
That is good.
Yeah. Yeah, we know your schedule.
Whether or not, you know, I'm running around there with the kids, probably not. But
yeah. Well, maybe now you will. Maybe do a poll or
you're dead
run the bases or something.
Is it vitamin C from the sun?
Vitamin D.
You're getting vitamin D.
C is from orange juice.
Right.
Right. That's what I'm thinking.
Again, not a science podcast. Radiocast. We get the gist of it. So if you're listening out there, try doing something new, something hard. I don't know. Get yourself out there, engage with the world.
Yeah. I was thinking about this quote. It's like very common.
Oh, motivation quotes here.
Well, it's like it's just like if you're not doing something that makes you like uncomfortable, then you're not living.
That's right. And I don't know, just don't get sucked in to screens and all that stuff when you want to be living.
Right.
Yeah. Good stuff. Look at us getting emotional.
That was
deep.
An incredible way to end the segment.
Deep. Oh God!
Is this a better podcast now?
Maybe it is. Today it is.
I mean, other things, anything we want.
Oh man! Well, we got another song.
Yep.
This is Sarah's pick.
It's called "End of Beginning."
Another version of me. I was in it.
I liked that. I feel like I've heard it.
That is Steve from Stranger Things.
No.
Yeah.
Wow.
Who crazy, knew? Right? Yeah.
That is crazy.
Huh.
Not bad.
Yeah.
Where'd he go, Steve?
I didn't even know.
Harrington, right? No. Yeah.
That's it.
Steve Harrington.
Steve Harrington.
Yeah.
What's his real name?
Joe Carey.
Yeah.
He's had a band for like years, but like, I don't think they ever like blew up or anything. But then I was hearing this song because it's like huge on TikTok, and I had no idea it was him.
See, people blowing up on TikTok.
Yeah.
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 Giving power to the people.
So everyone's like, he is just waiting for Stranger Things to be over, probably to like run on this momentum now.
Yeah. That's cool. So we're winding down here, but one other thing happening, the total eclipse of the heart. No.
Yeah.
Of the moon, of the sun.
Yeah.
However it works.
When is that?
The 8th, right? 8th,
Tuesday.
3 days.
Oh, okay.
Sun four, yeah.
4 days.
So So I'll be here at work during the day. I can't boogie on over. But did you see there was a map of Airbnb bookings? And like it was like percent occupancy, and it was like 100% along the route,
the belt
of the path of the eclipse.
That's crazy.
And so like people are packed in, and like small towns are declaring local emergencies for how many visitors they're expecting.
Oh gosh!
Because people are just gonna try to be cramming in on the.
Can't you like still pretty much see it even if you're like a little off?
Right. It'll be like we're gonna see a partial eclipse.
Yeah,
you see those all the time. It's the total eclipse that's like the really cool one, and that's the one that
you can take off
your shades because the sun's completely blocked. And that's kind of like that's the big spectacle.
That's the thing.
What's it
it's when you can't see anything?
Wait, it's blocked, so you don't need sunglasses.
Yeah, for like a minute,
You
can look at the sun without protective glasses. Because the sun is completely blocked. You're looking at the moon.
Right.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's what the eclipse is.
Right. Yes.
I thought it was super bright.
No.
That's so something else,
so it's
right?
Earth, moon, sun, right?
Yeah. The moon, right.
Moon's in the middle.
I'd be very concerned if the sun was in the middle.
No, but I thought, isn't there something where, like, you do need the glasses?
Yes. For this, anything. That's not the complete total eclipse. Don't look up at it because there is still the sun. That's why they say.
Oh, the glasses just so that you're already looking for when it eclipses and then you can take them off.
Right.
Correct.
Okay.
But for anything that's not.
So before and after.
This is a public service announcement. For anything that's not the total eclipse, and again, that's like you have 30 seconds.
Right.
You need protective glasses because the sun is still behind the moon there and you will be staring at the sun. That's why, remember that partial eclipse when Trump was president and there's the meme of him like looking up and pointing at it?
Yes.
Because that was just like a partial eclipse and everyone was like, don't look at it unless you have the things.
So that's what
and
I was thinking.
And then there
is
the president in the United States being like,
Yeah.
Right.
Because I was at the beach that day and I remember the lifeguards had to like these teenage lifeguards were like, no one looked up at the sun.
Right.
But it's so cool. Look at what it's doing.
I grabbed like 10 sunglasses. I had like a bunch of like cheap sunglasses laying around. So I like stacked them together and like looked at it.
Nice.
Because I did not have like the.
Right. They're like super duper dark. Like 10 or 20 times darker than sunglasses or something.
Right.
Yeah.
Because it turns everything else pretty much black except for the sun.
So do we know, like, what time that happened? Like, when can we see it?
I think it's in the afternoon on the 8th here.
Right. So we'll see a partial eclipse.
I guess probably everyone will go out and look at it.
Yeah.
I feel like.
Gotta get your solar.
Well, it's the first time in, like, 80 years, right?
I think it's the first time in that, like, the total eclipse path has crossed the United States. Because only a small sliver is the total eclipse.
Yeah, it's like Mexico to Maine.
Right.
So this
like
is
Niagara
like Falls,
it's going to cross over Niagara Falls, and Niagara Falls is expecting like millions of people to crowd.
There's, we have a place up in Moosehead. We're not going to go, but if we could have, we would have been in the total eclipse.
That's awesome. I would have taken the day off. Can I go to Moosehead?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Hudson Library is having
an
eclipse party.
Yeah.
Like a viewing party.
They ran out of the free, they were giving out free solar things. They ran out.
Yeah.
But they're having like an all afternoon party.
Nice.
We can just like stream it and then we can look at it.
Yeah.
That's true.
Via a live stream.
There's probably going to be so many of the people that went in the path are probably like photographers. And
oh, yeah. Definitely.
There's going to be a billion pictures, time lapses of it. And, yeah.
I saw that there's over like there's hundreds of weddings that were booked specifically like for that time. Oh.
That's crazy.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
They want to be able to say they got married during the total eclipse.
A total eclipse of the heart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
You got to play the song.
Absolutely. <Right. laughs> I might just play the song anyway. Just for
if we all go out on Tuesday, like we should wheel out
the big speaker.
Huge speaker and play that.
Yeah. Oh man.
That is cool though. I feel like an idiot for not knowing what that meant. I was like, oh, the sun's gonna be really bright. Why do we care?
What's the lunar eclipse would be the other.
The lunar eclipse would be if the Earth was between the sun and the moon.
Yes.
And then the moon gets like red.
Yes.
Which that was happens. I think when I was in college that happened.
Yeah.
That was
I think those are slightly more frequent or something.
Right, yeah.
Because we had UMass Amherst had an observatory by one of the dorm that I lived in. So a bunch of us like walked over and they like opened it up that night. And
oh, that's
like
cool.
Let us look through.
That's cool.
It was pretty cool.
Yeah, some people get real into this whole.
Well, yeah, first one in 80 years or whatever. That's across the United States.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not every day this happens, guys.
But does it change anything?
Yeah, it's really cool.
You can't even look at it unless you have glasses on.
The sun is 400 times bigger than the moon, but the moon is 400 times closer than the sun.
Perfect.
That's what creates the perfect.
So is it going to get dark?
Yeah.
Like the sky will be dark too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It like turns to night when you're in the path.
But it'll get like shady even if you're not, I think, right?
We'll probably get a little bit dark, yeah.
We have to go outside.
Yeah.
We're also pretty close to
we are pretty close.
Light.
We'll get a pretty good
yeah.
coverage. I don't know percentage
it's
or
not
whatever.
It's not going to be like exactly in the thing, so we might not get it perfect, but we're going to get like a pretty good pretty good view. Well, anyways.
I don't know if you guys knew about this solar eclipse. This sounds pretty cool.
Well, now you know. It's a good thing you tuned in. And, and watched the whole thing
good
to
thing
the
I
end.
Right.
Didn't know any of this.
Oh, man. Yeah, it's happening on Tuesday. There you go.
Now you know.
Well, thanks for tuning in. Cam, Jared, and Sarah. See you next time.
See you next time.